A very good morning. Welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss about the program number 7. This is under ISS and OAS lab. So we are going to find out the shortest remaining time and round robin scheduling algorithms over here. So now we'll see the main difference between these two things. So shortest remaining time, how it came. So this is the primitive version of the SJF. So shortest job first, that is the non-primitive, and then abandon, and although we have the primitive version of the shortest remaining time first. And so here in this round robin, what we are going to see is we have a process ID, and then we have a burst time, and then by using these two things we are going to find out, and we have a Gantt chart, and by using this we are going to calculate. So in round robin scheduling algorithms, what we are going to do is we are going to find out the turnaround time and then waiting time. So turnaround time is having a formula called completion time minus arrival time. So in some problems we have the arrival time, but in some cases we have a arrival time called zero. So completion time, so we have a Gantt chart. So in that, based on that process, where our process is going to end, that is a thing we are going to take it as a completion time, and then completion time, then afterwards arrival time we can take it for the. So if we are going to find out this completion time minus arrival time, we can get the turnaround time. So if we need a waiting time, means we have to find out the turnaround time minus burst time, then we can get the waiting time. So based on this concept, we are going to see the coding. So this is a program we are going to develop and implement the program to simulate the working of shortest remaining time and round robin scheduling algorithms, and we are going to have a quantum sizes for the round robin algorithms. So now we'll see the coding part. We have a standard input output library, and we are using the struct type structure name called proc, and then we have the data type, and for that we have a variable. So int id, arrival, burst and remaining and waiting time. We already discussed about this the round robin algorithms. We have an arrival time, burst time, and then waiting time. So now we'll see the things. This is the structure to hold the process information so that we are giving the process often. So this is the state. This is how the structure is going to end, and it is going to hold the process information. And then we'll see the round robin process now. So in this main function, we have an the execution starts over here. So int n, tq and choice and burst time, and then waiting time, and then ijk, and then we are using the for statement, and then we are going to see the schedule. Here we are going to print the round robin, then shortest remaining time first and exit. So we are going to print. We can give any kind of choice, either if it is if you are pressing 1, then we'll be getting the output called round robin. If you are choosing second option, then we can find the shortest remaining time first and exit. And so we are going to read the ampersand choice. So ampersand choice is nothing but we are going to scan the choice, and then we are using the switch statement that we are using the round robin scheduling algorithms, and in this we are going to enter the number of process, again burst time, so we are going to get the burst time, and then service time, and then quantum sizes will be here. So at last we are going to end in function to start over. Then the process, if it continues, then we can give the count, that is it's going to get incremented. The when service time of a process greater than then quantum, this value gets subtracted from the service time. And then temp, we are using for a temporary statement to store the things in the temp variable. So temp one stores the service time of a process and make service time equals to zero. So here we are utilizing the temp one value to calculate the turnaround time. So we already know the turnaround time is going to calculate it by using the formula called the completion time minus burst arrival time. So by using this formula we can get the turnaround time, and then it just indicates all the process have completed the task, because the count value is going to increment when service time equals to zero. And we can easily calculate waiting time by finding the turnaround time. We can easily find the waiting time, that is turnaround time minus burst time. So this is the summation of turnaround time, and this is the summation of waiting time. We are going to see the output like this. This is the output. So now we'll see how we are going to compile the things in the code part. going to open my a program. So this is the shortest remaining time first and round robin algorithms. This part we have seen already. So in this we are going to see the completion, the round robin compilation and all. So there is no any errors over here, and we can view the number of process, number of resources per process one we have given like this. So we get for the process 2, 3, and we can give any type of process. Process 3, again we are going to see, we are going to give. So for each process, so for process 2, for process 3, so available resources. So now the statement call like this. So this is how I can thank you. So this is how we can